Hi all, I am Dr.Hirennappa B Udnur, pulmonologist practicing at Inspire Speciality Clinic, Sahakar, Nagar, Bengaluru. COPD has been categorized according to newer guidelines as A, B and E. The earlier groups as C and D are combined as exacerbation. There was more symptoms or less symptoms, more exacerbation and less exacerbation. The more exacerbation is exacerbation A and D are combined. So A and B, A and C, these groups are called more of mild COPD or early stages of COPD, and this is the three groups which are staged now at latest GINA, and the differentiating factor between predominant and emphysema, the time immemorial, we know predominant emphysema, pink puffers and blue bloaters, and they have more of leg swelling, cyanosis and other things, and they are overweight, and pink puffers more of emphysema or more of thin built hyperinflated lung fields. That's the way we differentiate the patient type phenotypes. And symptoms wise, they have more of cough with expectoration, they have more breathlessness, and PFTs are showing certain things which are DLCO is reduced, and PFT showing obstruction with partial reversibility. That's how we differentiate clinically, and based on the symptom emphysema and bronchitis. On occasion of old COPD day, which is celebrated, we need to stick on giving a symptomatic treatment in early stages, and definitely when it is needed in the presence of eosinophilia and recurrent exacerbation, we may require inhaled steroid in practice. Many patients know that they have COPD, and it's a complex terminology, COPD. Many patients don't feel, understand their disease well. We try to tell them it is more of asthma like disease. COPD is a specific entity which happens in people who are exposed to smoking and indoor and external air pollutions, and sometimes environmental or genetic risks which are associated. Predominantly, they are being associated with shortness of breath and exertion with or without wheeze, and cough with expectorations on and off. And sometimes during exacerbations, they are more breathless, and which might require steroids and other things. I want to make sure that COPD is an important disease in respiratory practice, and it adds most of volumes in our routine respiratory practice, and it should be differentiated from asthma. That's the biggest thing we need to do, and identify smokers who are COPD. They are not smoking COPD patients are also there. They have predominant emphysema or bronchitis, and this awareness which requires long-term treatment for COPD with bronchodilators early and inhaled steroid at later stage, and if they have eosinophilia, and that is good to know about this disease well, because in the natural history of disease, COPD is hampered by frequent exacerbations. I need to spread this message among the general public that COPD is a disease which comes with lung attacks.